So again, we're talking about measures of central tendency. And just to remind you, that's a single score that best describes all the scores we've collected. We already talked about the mode, now we're going to talk about the median. So the median is a score that divides the distribution in half when the observations are ordered. Now, sometimes students get the median and the mean mixed up, so my goal today is to make sure you feel the clarity in the difference between the two. So the steps behind doing the median are first that you have to order your observations. So if you're looking at height, you would put people in order of height. If you're looking at how much money someone makes, then you put them in order by how much money they make. So once you put them in order, then you divide that distribution in half. So if it's height, you put them in order of height and you figure out where's the middle spot. So that half the people are on the left and half the people are on the right. And then once you've split them in half, you find out what score really defines that middle spot. So I'm going to tell you a couple techniques for how to do that so you know you've certainly found the middle location. But the goal is that we're not looking at the mathematical center, right? The mean would be that you add them all up and divide by two or divide by how many there are. But the median is that you put your distribution in order and then you figure out what score marks where half the people are on the left and half the people are on the right. So these are, I put in quotes, calculations, because some of them aren't really calculations, but these are the techniques that we would use to calculate the median. So I'm going to use these fake data set up there. Let's just say this is dollars in your pocket. So I coined this technique, the BOOP technique. It's an easy way, if you have a very small data set, to kind of visualize where the median is. And then we're going to learn the math technique, which this is saying n plus 1 divided by 2. So this is the mathematical technique for calculating where the median would be. So let's first do the BOOP technique. So what you would do is you would, especially if it's a small data set like this, you take your fingers and you place them on the outside numbers. So here I put them on the 3 and the 0. And then I would put my fingers and go in the next set. BOOP. And then I would go in the next set. Boop. And so by doing this, I can see that I've landed where the middle score splits. There's three scores on the left, there's three scores on the right. My median is 1. Let me go back and just show you again how that looks. So what you do is you put your fingers on the outside numbers and you say boop, and then you do boop, and then you do boop, and you find the median score. Now, obviously, if you have a huge data set of like 150 numbers, that would be annoying to be like boop, 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 right, until you find the middle score. But this helps you kind of see what the goal of the median is. We put them in order. The numbers had to be in order. But once they're in order, we're kind of just getting down to where the score is that marks where half are on the left and half are on the right. Well, now let me teach you the mathematical approach. So what we would do is we want to look at our sample size. And so N stands for the count of observations. In this case, we have 7 scores. So like if you count them with me, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 scores. So in our formula, we have to account for how many scores there are. So the way we would do this is we would take our number, 7, plus the 1, divide by 2. So that means it would be 8 divided by 2, in which case the answer is 4. So if that confuses you, we can go back through it again. But we have 7 scores, and so we're plugging it into this equation down at the bottom down here. And what we've said is we have 7 scores, and so the equation requires we take that 7 plus 1 divided by 2. That totals 8 divided by 2, and that totals 4. And so what that tells us is not that the median was 4, because notice in my data set there are no 4s, so my median can't be 4. But what it is, it's the 4th spot. So this equation tells you which spot you would find the median in. And so if we actually look at our data and we move over 4 spots, 0, 1, 1, 1, we find that the median is 1. So both techniques will give you the same answer. It's just one is kind of useful for small data sets and you're just going boop, 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 boop. And then the other one is where you're using the actual mathematical model. And in my in-person classes, I do find sometimes I hear a little boop, 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 boop. But it is a technique if you're not into formulas. And then some of you really like formulas, and so this other technique works for you. Well, now let's talk about this one. Actually was nice because it was an odd number of scores. We had 7. So we landed on this nice score in the middle. But what happens if we have an even number of scores? So let's go through those two techniques using an even number of scores. So let's say that I take the zero off. So remember, we had a zero on there. Now I only have six scores and I've removed the zero. So let's try our boop technique. So we say, boop, boop, oh. Okay, so once we try to boop, we realize we've landed where there's two scores in the middle. So one is, on the left is one, on the right is two. Now we have to come up with one score that best represents everybody. Is there a way I can take that one and that two and have a number that represents the halfway in between mark? So hopefully your brain said, oh, 1.5. 1.5 is halfway between one and two. That's right. So mathematically, what you do is you take the two scores, you add them together, and then you divide by two. So we would say 2 plus 1, which is 3, divided by 2, that's 1.5. Now, the reason I'm being dramatic about this, because it might have been really clear to you that it was 1.5, is let's say this was a 10 and a 20. So 10 and 20 are not going to have a 10.5 as the halfway mark. Right? It's going to be 10 plus 20 divided by 2, which would be 15. So whatever numbers are here, you have to add them together and divide by 2 to find the score that's halfway between the two. So in this case, using the boop technique, we actually had to go ahead and do some math. So I apologize. I try to avoid doing math whenever possible, but it still had to happen. So we booped it until the point where we had to average and find out that the median was 1.5. Now let's go ahead and use the mathematical approach. If you're not a booping fan, or let's say you have 1,000 scores and you have to figure out where the median is. We still use the same equation of n plus 1 divided by 2, and n still stands for the number of observations. In this case, we have 6. So we're going to say 6 plus 1 divided by 2, that's 7 divided by 2, that's 3.5. So remember, that's not the median is not 3.5. The median is in the 3.5 spot. So what you see here is we have 1, 2, 3.5. So we have to figure out what's halfway between 1 and 2. So even though we use the math approach, we still have to do this averaging between 1 and 2 like we did with the booping technique. So essentially, it's not that complicated it's super easy if you have an odd number of scores. But if you have an even number of scores, you just have to do the extra step of finding the number that fits between the two middle spots. And that will be the median for your data set. So let's talk about the pros and the cons of the median. Pros, it's not influenced by extreme scores. So let's say if that was dollars in your pocket, somebody there had 300. Well, they're still going to be on the end just the same as somebody who had $3 on the end. So having $300 in your pocket isn't going to change which score is in the median. You know, if I replaced that end 3 with 3,000, right, it's not going to change that the middle score was still 1.5. So that's nice that we don't have scores that are influenced by outliers or extreme scores. We can actually calculate the median for ordinal data. So let's say an example of ordinal data would be class standing, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. Let's say I ask people what their standing is and they say freshman, sophomore, junior. So I have freshman, sophomore, junior. Oh, let's make it odd just to make it friendly. So freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. So if I have an odd number, I have 5 scores there, then I have freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. I can see that sophomore is in between. And so I now have a median response for ordinal data. Now the hiccup is, it only works if you had an odd number of ordinal data, right? Because if we have even number, you can't be halfway between a freshman and a sophomore. However, it would work if it were even data if they were the same. So if it was, let's say the actual data were freshman, sophomore. Well, the median would be halfway between a freshman and a freshman, which is a freshman. So the working with ordinal data, it does, but only in certain circumstances, whether you either have an odd set of data, odd number, an odd count, or it's an even count, but it's flanking the same score, so it doesn't really matter. So that's something to think about, that if you have ordinal data where it's even, but it's not flanking the same number, we can't find a median for that. It's, you know, a lot of books will say it's easier to compute than the mean. I would say, yeah, especially if you're just booping. However, if you have to find the average between two scores, that actually is the mean. So that's kind of a silly pro to put, but I wanted to put it there in case you read it in the books. If you have to calculate the mean to get the median, then it clearly is not easier to calculate than the mean. The downsides of the median. Well, now we are actually in a circumstance where we might end up with data that didn't exist in the data set. So like we saw 1.5. There was no 1.5 in the data set, but we ended up with that. And once again, we're also ignoring a lot of the data. So if we have somebody with $3,000 in their pocket, notice that we ignored them. And we were like, well, the average is 1.5. So it is important as statisticians that we recognize that we may be missing out on important data and ignoring things.